Player 2, this is Player 1, plugging in.
Player 1 is initiating connection. Player 1 is online.
Player 1, this is Player 2, plugging in.
Player 2 is initiating connection. Player 2 is online. All players have successfully connected. You are now plugged into the Plug and Play podcast. Initiating startup sequence.
Hey guys, and thank you for tuning in to episode 130, which is technically like number 13, because like zero technically isn't a number, it means like it's numbers.
Or four if you add them all together.
Four if you add it all together.
130 sounds bigger though.
130 does sound way bigger.
By the way, welcome minions.
Yeah, I'm Zach, and alongside me as always is Tim. He already said welcome minions. Yep. He didn't wait for me to get to that part. I was gonna wait. I was just gonna go for like 30 minutes.
Yeah, that's me cutting you off.
Alright, sounds good. So I'm cut off.
Yep, you're cut off.
Alright, so I'm cut off. So you're on.
Okay, so what I've been doing this week. Not a whole lot, but we did have a weird incident last night while I was at work. Got caught on our ring camera. There was a white shark pulling back and forth like 5 times. And then this girl cuts like through our property, like right in front of our house,
yeah,
like, through our lawn, and goes to meet him. And I think we can play that clip right here.
Yeah.
For those of you on YouTube.
Exactly.
So that was weird. So while I was at work, it was Super Bowl night, or am I allowed to say Super Bowl? I'm always confused because people are saying like the big game. Like
it's the Super Bowl.
It's weird. It's like they want everybody to know about it, but they don't want anybody to say it.
It's a Super Bowl.
It's a stupid American thing. Like everywhere else, it's the World Cup or whatever.
Yeah,
it's the big game. Like they'll sue you if you call it the big in advertisements. If you call it
the Super Bowl.
Yeah, if you advertise like a Super Bowl party. Or,
really?
Or you know, get your snacks for the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Look at the paper next time. It's like, get your snacks for the big game.
Really?
Yes.
I never even noticed that.
It's really weird. Like
that's really stupid.
It is. They want endorsements from everyone.
Okay.
It's really dumb.
Yeah, that's really stupid.
Lose a lot of respect to my opinion. Anyway, yeah. I was at work for the Super Bowl while the weirdness was happening in front of my house.
Well, that was the day after the Super Bowl the weirdness happened.
Oh, right.
Yeah, because that was last night.
Okay, it all blurs together for me. So anyway, it was a slow night. Really slow.
You were sending me, you were playing your Vita at work.
I actually clocked off for half an hour and played one of the games that I'm going to bring it up later.
That's funny.
Yeah.
That's real funny.
It was that slow. It was bad. I did get to watch most of the halftime show because of that.
So that's cool.
Lady Gaga was entertaining.
It was entertaining.
My favorite part was the drones overhead.
That was really cool.
So for those
I didn't realize there were drones until later on.
For those of you who didn't get to see it, there were drones flying in formations with LEDs on them.
Yeah.
So they would like spell out Pepsi or a flag.
It's Intel's new...
They got like an Intel Swarm technology that...
Yeah, so Intel made this technology and they're going to be selling it to marketers.
Mm-hmm.
And so now basically, not only are we going to have billboards along the street, they're like advertising this as like, they're going to be selling airspace for like advertisers now.
So all these drones make up a pixel and they can make moving images.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
And quick moving images too. I mean like instant. Or like they would change colors or something.
I'm just saying.
That would be like penises in the sky.
Yes.
Penis
flying,
in the sky.
Flying penises.
Flying penises. We are being invaded by the... Oh my god, we can make a cow fly or a pig fly.
Put a plug and play everywhere.
We can put plug and play everywhere.
Yes.
World domination.
We need to hack these drones.
We should.
Alright, go ahead and erase that part of the podcast.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay.
Yep, it's gone.
And then the only other real notable thing was I made my first meal and the Instapot, that tech talk thing.
It didn't blow up.
It did not blow up.
Okay.
And it made good food. It took... You know, all the preparation time, other than that, it took a half hour to cook a huge bowl of good chili. Like
really?
Tender, good.
Like, enough chili for one person or for two?
For four people, twice.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Good bowl of chili. I froze over half of it.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. And it tasted good? And
yep. And a three-bean chili with beef, and I could make it a little spicier next time. I just went by the recipe for this time. But it was super easy. You just brown the beef, then throw all the other ingredients in there.
Okay.
Beans and tomato paste and tomato chunks.
Yeah.
Spices. Turn it on. Just do whatever.
Come on, wait for 30 minutes, come back.
Yeah, I don't know if you've ever made chili, but usually it takes like several hours for the beans to...
Yeah, cook. Soak everything in.
Yeah, soak in and get soft.
Yeah.
It's 30 minutes of cooking time. Now, it does take time to get up to pressure.
Mm-hmm.
So actual time in the pot was probably like 45 minutes.
Okay.
But again, that's just time where I'm doing whatever I want to do.
You're not cooking.
No.
Yeah.
Just prep time and set it and go.
That's cool.
That was cool. That was my first official meal of that thing. It was good. So I just had to bring it up since I...
Just so you guys know, I don't have any viruses on the PC.
This time. Oh, but my daughter does. She downloaded some malware.
Your dad's been looking at porn.
I'm not sure it was that, but like...
Did you bring it with you?
I meant to, I forgot.
Okay.
Yeah,
she texted me. She's like, so my screen says this, and daddy doesn't know how to fix it. He says that you will.
I went to uninstall programs, and it said, this program's already been installed, and then it hit itself. Like... You're not fooling me.
Yeah.
Are you just hiding?
That sucks.
Yeah. I don't know what it's doing, but I don't like it.
But it still popped up.
Yeah, it still pops up. Yeah. But it'll tell you you've uninstalled it. It's a bunch of crap.
And what is it?
I don't know. I'm not going to click on the link that it pops up.
Okay. What does it do when is it a program that pops up?
It pops up on the top of every browser now.
Oh, really?
The little tiny tab.
Really?
And I'm not about to click the little tiny tab.
Yeah, no, don't do that. That's weird.
Yes, it's annoying. Yeah. I don't know what she did, but she did it, basically the day before she called you.
Huh. Strange.
Yeah, because I could see the install date, and there's two programs.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
That's always fun.
At least, two that are visible.
Yeah, exactly. We'll see.
It's like whack-a-mole.
It'll be fun.
But that's my week, more or less. What have you been up to?
Just hanging out with the baby. He's growing, super fucking fast.
I saw.
So he's out of newborns. He's in size one now.
Yeah.
And,
is he sleeping more?
Today he has been. So that onesie that you guys got us was, huge on him. This is a onesie I tried to bring him home in. And there was, no way. Right. His feet, barely touched the crotch of it. And he was born, and he was a big boy. So that's a pretty big onesie. Fucking thing fits him perfectly now. So, I mean, he grew quite a bit.
Only in a week.
We're on week 3.
I was going to say 4, but...
It's almost... Well, technically tomorrow will be 4. Okay. So, yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, so
that's
big boy.
To do.
Yeah. So, other than that, I've been looking at gun safes. Because...
When he starts crawling, you want them all secured?
Well, and I don't really want to open this up on the podcast, but, let's just say behind you there's a couple of them just chilling.
Yeah.
And...
Oh, that's nice for me.
Something
goes down.
Exactly. There's a couple of them just chilling there.
You go for the master sword, I'll go for the guns.
Sounds good. And then there's just a few other in random places throughout the property, I should say. That
you
are.
You ever seen those hidden bookshelves where you tap it and it swings down and it's right there for you?
Mine's kind of hey, move this chair and all of a sudden you got two rifles. So, yeah, but I really do want one of the bookcases or the shelves.
Those look cool.
Yeah, they look really cool. So I need to figure out something just for when he starts to crawl. I mean, ammo's nearby, all of them, but it's not loaded, and not like he can load a gun and stuff. But I don't really feel comfortable with that. There is one weapon that obviously I'm not going to put in the gun safe, which is my home protection weapon.
Well, you put lock on it, right?
I got to figure out a way to...
They make small boxes that you can trigger open really fast.
Yeah, exactly. I need to find one of those.
And they're typically 50 to 70 bucks.
That's not bad. That's fine. So I've been looking...
Should have everyone secured.
Yeah. So I've been looking at... Actually, I was looking at a little... it almost looks like a tin box that's like that, but it's got a thumbprint, so you just roll over, put your thumb on it, pops open.
Well, that would work for you, Stubby.
Thumb. I got two thumbs. Not fingerprint. And actually, you know what I was also thinking about? And I thought about this a few times. You commit a crime, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you just do what I did. Your fingerprints are gone. They're never going to convince
you. You can do that once.
Well, no, you do it. You just cut one finger at a time.
I know, but it, you'll be palming people.
Yeah. Yeah. They make,
I'm just saying.
They make prosthetic shit.
That's not quite good enough yet. They 3D print some stuff. But.
Yeah, that's true. Anyways, so gun safes.
Mm-hmm.
I've been looking at them. Costco has a pretty nice one for about $600. It's big. It's a 24 gun safe with a side panel, and it comes with all the ammo clips. Or ammo pouches and pistol pouches on the backside of the door. with three big bolts coming out of the side. No up and down bolts, which kind of pissed me off, but still three big bolts. It's digital and backup key combo.
That sounds nicer than mine. Mine's pretty simple.
But yours is not a 24 gun safe, no. Though. Yours is like a 12, maybe?
It might call itself that, but I would think you could fit more than six, really.
Yeah.
That's plenty for what I have.
Yeah.
As far as long rifles, but...
Yeah. So
not a lot of pistol storage. It's kind of cramped in there, and I end up having to store my ammo outside of it, which I don't really like.
Yeah.
But there's just no room.
Yeah. So I was actually, while I was at Costco, ran into a older gentleman that had a, what was it, Vietnam hat on or something like that. He's military branch of some kind.
Mm-hmm.
And he said that they had a really nice one down at Bi-Mart.
You should check Bi-Mart. They always have some.
And he actually said that it was pretty much the same as that gun safe, just different brand.
Mm-hmm.
So I might run down there and check them out as well.
If you're spending that much money, you should definitely shop around.
Yeah. So we'll see. I need to figure out something. Obviously,
you're
I got
have
a few months.
Hand truck from experience.
He said that Costco will deliver it for you.
Will they put it in the room that you want it to be in?
I want it in the garage.
Then you're probably fine.
Yeah. I mean, I don't have room for it in any of my rooms is a problem.
Mine in the back of a... Well, I'm going to say what mine is.
Yeah. Mine won't be in the garage permanently, let's put it that way.
Yep.
So, been doing that. I found a awesome sweatshirt I sent you a link to.
Yes, you did.
So, I got the wife's approval on it. She actually really liked it, so that's the reason why I bought
it's a good
it.
Good sweatshirt. Cool.
So I bought a Zelda Breath of the Wild limited edition sweatshirt from... Was it called Merchoid?
Sure, if you say so. So limited edition just means they only printed a certain number. That's not really...
Well, I think it's a certain... They're like... They didn't make a certain number of them. They're like selling it through a certain date.
Oh, okay.
So, actually, no, there was a certain number because there was only two left in medium. So I got one of the two. Basically, it's a blue. It's the Breath of the Wild blue that you see Link wearing on his T-shirt. And on the back of it has a huge Breath of the Wild Z with the Master Sword coming through.
How do you feel about that, by the way? That he's marketing it as blue this time instead of green?
Mm.
I mean, I know you can change clothes in the game. Like you're not,
yeah,
you
so
don't,
like,
you're not
I don't,
set in that. But they are showing that a lot.
Yeah, he's definitely in a lot more blue. I'm hoping there's going to be a green outfit in there somewhere.
I guarantee it.
But, I mean, it doesn't bug me so much because they've kind of, like, this one's completely off track from everything else, and a lot of the newer Zelda stuff doesn't have him in typically green.
A blue Wind Waker as well.
Yeah, and he,
Wasn't there a fire suit in the game, one of the games, so it's red?
Yeah, Ocarina of Time had blue, green, red... Yeah, blue, green, red. So, and it has, like, gold cuffs on it that go up almost up, like, the entire forearm on it that are gold.
Cool.
I don't know. Send out a photo when I get it. So, I'm not sure when I'm going to get it. Other than that, I also went to the comic book shop and got my comic book collection more organized.
Oh, okay.
So, that's I also cool. picked up more comics.
I was going to say, that's what I expected to hear.
So
how many comics have you read this week?
Shut up, Tim.
That's what you're supposed to do with them, you know, not just collect them and organize them. Don't kill your guitar.
I don't think I can lift this, but... There is...
Oh, wow, it's a long box.
This is my comics. So, I bought this thinking this is really cool. Because not like they're going to be able to see what they're doing. Slides out.
Nice.
But I also found that that's really stupid.
Why?
Because I have these little...
Tabs?
Yeah. And they're a little tall.
So they scratch on the top?
Yeah.
Well, it still works.
Still works. But the next one I get, probably, because this one's almost full.
Usually they just open the top.
I'm probably going to buy the one that opens on the top next time. It's like $3 less. I thought this would be all cool because it's all more expensive. It was the deluxe edition. And I found out when I got home, I was like, this is stupid.
That's how you charge Zach another $5 to $25. Just add limited edition or deluxe at the end of the name.
Yeah, it sucks. Just so you guys know, don't do that. It's rude. It's mean. And it's degrading.
It's hilarious.
So that's what I've been up to this week. Cool. I swear to God, I'm gonna read comics this week, so hold me to it for next week. I gotta read at least all my Walking Dead comics.
Just start reading. You're not gonna read all of them.
I mean, it's only a stack that tall.
I just wanna see you read some.
I know.
Anything.
Okay. I gotta read.
You do?
Yeah.
Because, yeah, reading is important.
But I got a lot of room to store more collectible stuff now.
Oh, great.
I know! It's awesome! I was pretty psyched about that.
You do have more room up there now.
I do. There's nothing up there except for two Walking Dead books.
There you go.
So, anyways, that's what I've been up to this week, but we like to talk about video games sometimes.
I didn't play that many this week.
Me either.
I played a bit of Rise of the Tomb Raider, which continues to be awesome. Okay. I was kind of doing some side quests this time, finding some tombs to explore, and I wanted to make some ammo pouches, so I was hunting rabbits and wolves. So that was fun.
Okay.
Got through one little tomb, and that's really about it. So I didn't advance the story any.
Okay.
Just trying to get my, level up lore a little bit.
Yeah.
I guess there's gonna be another movie coming out soon, a reboot.
Hmm.
Not Angelina Jolie, some.
No, yeah.
Actress who looks the part, but I've never heard of her.
Yeah, I never heard of her either.
She's
probably, now that you mentioned
she's
it.
Probably just more athletic than being like an amazing actress, but hopefully she's got range at that as well.
Probably.
Another movie that's coming out that you probably would like. Did you see the original John Wick? Keanu Reeves is like this assassin.
Huh.
And like the people, somebody kills his wife? Yeah, his wife, I think, and he goes out for revenge. And it's really cool.
Huh.
They have the gun fu in the movie where it's like...
the gun battle?
It's awesome. Like, you would like it.
Okay.
Maybe try to find it on video. See if you want to go see John Wick 2 with me, because I want to go see it.
Okay.
But games. Back to games. I played Rise of the Tomb Raider. I played a little bit of Stranded. A Mars adventure. It's kind of like a runner on Mars.
Okay.
It's a little...
There's a Stranded game I've wanted to check out on Steam.
Oh, Stranded : A Mars Adventure.
Okay.
That's what I was playing my Vita at work.
Okay.
I played like four or five levels.
Nice.
You gotta run fast because you're running out of oxygen. That's the biggest mechanic. And
as you run faster, the oxygen goes down quicker?
No, but you can use a jetpack, which makes it go down way fast.
How the fuck does a jetpack make your oxygen go down? Running would make your oxygen run down.
Well, a jetpack would shoot jets of air to make you double jump.
Oh, but he has a mask on?
Yeah, he doesn't have a space.
Never mind. Okay, that makes more sense.
It handles the lower gravity pretty well. Like, the jumps are definitely floaty.
Really? That's cool.
Little short levels. It was something I could pick up and play for, 10 minutes of work.
Mm-hmm.
Although I ended up playing it for 40. And then the last thing I tried to play was something I got for you, too, which I think is going to end up being a total fail.
BattleBorne?
Yeah.
Okay.
Remember when we saw this at PAX?
Yes.
Did you see the price tag on that?
Yeah.
Go show the camera.
$4.99.
And I actually got it for $4.50 because I have that Gamer Club unlocked thing. So I bought two. And I was trying to play it today, but it would not let you start it up without the update file. Which was 15 gigs.
Holy shit!
So just before I came here, I finally got it downloaded, and I just booted it up just to see the lobby.
Is there anybody on there?
Yes, but I jumped out before the game started because I'm a dick. I was just in the prologue anyway with a bunch of other newbies, so it didn't really matter. So I got this for you because I know there's a mode in it that's two-player couch co-op.
Really?
But then I was reading the back, and I think you have to have PlayStation Plus to play.
Oh, goddammit. Okay.
So I'm going to let you play with
Check it out.
Make sure I'm right. If not, I'll give it to somebody at work.
Okay.
There's two guys I know that have PlayStations at work. They'll probably like it.
Okay.
But you got first shot at it. It was dirt cheap, so I bought two.
Sweet. Awesome. Thank you.
But yeah, it just came out. Like, it seems like not that long ago, and then... now it's $5.
Yeah, that's sad. And I think I had BattleBorne was on Humble Bundle at one point.
Was it?
I think so. Cause I think
like,
I
the characters
Steam.
Look really cool, and it looks like kind of a fun multiplayer shooter.
Yeah, we had fun with it at PAX.
Mm-hmm. But, yeah, $5.
That's crazy. $5 freaking. I mean, it is pre-owned, but still, for $5 freaking.
Yep. They had tons of them.
Let's see how well they took care of the disc. Not a single scratch.
Nice. There you go. Make sure I'm right.
Okay, I'll make sure you're right.
After you spend 2 days downloading the updated file.
Jesus. 15 freaking gigs?
It's 15 or 16.
Jesus.
It's a lot.
It's a lot.
And it would not let you do anything before that.
Really?
You get to the screen, you push X, you're like, need update file. Screw you. It does say right on the box, requires internet.
It does. This nice, beautiful black box, the very bottom of the disc.
I'm
kind of
annoyed. Like, I wish there was an offline campaign.
Yeah, I mean...
But I think I might have... I think you might be screwed.
I'm thinking you're probably right, but I will try it. You can do remote play with this.
I could play on my Vita, yes.
That's crazy.
It is crazy. I've played some games on remote play. It's kind of fun. Played some Fallout once. What was the name? There's a game I played recently that's not coming to mind, but... Yeah, card play game. Hand of Fate.
Yep.
That was good. That was a good play. Good game to play on.
Yeah.
Because it's... There are some action scenes, but there's a lot that's not that fast.
Hmm.
You got any kind of, like... You wouldn't want to play this kind of game on it. That would be a dumb game, actually. Anything with fast shooting, you don't want
would
to
be
play.
Terrible.
Yes.
Hmm.
So yeah, that's cool. What I sort of played, kind of.
Sweet. Well, I started out this week with some more Puzzle Quest.
So have you paid money into the system yet?
No.
Have you been tempted?
No.
Okay.
Talk to you about it off air.
Oh, okay. Well, so. Would the average player be tempted by the time it got to your level, be tempted to play, to pay
yes.
to play?
Yes. Does
it come to become?
I think they'd either get frustrated and just do the story missions, or... they would just say fuck it after the 3 heals that you get every 20 minutes and then just quit, probably, eventually. Yeah, probably. I mean, there's quite a few people in this one community I'm a part of that haven't paid for anything, but they also, like, don't make it anywhere near the leaderboards on these, like, tournaments they run.
Mm-hmm.
So, usually there's about 3,000 players in a run. The last one just closed out yesterday, and I finished 165 or something out of 3,000.
Not bad.
So, and the shitty part about how it works is, or shitty for me anyways, is like, say I'm at work for 10 hours a day. I come home, I've got my son, I'm helping my wife take care of him. And then I play a little bit before bed. I get up to, let's say, I think I was at like 90 or something like that. I went to sleep, and the thing closes out at, like, midnight, but, like, everybody else stayed playing, so it kicked me back up to, like, 100 and something. So I went from 90 to 100 and something and not playing, which, like, makes sense because it's a leaderboard and everybody else is playing and stuff, but it just really sucks that, like, my, like, reward went from being, like, a super awesome reward to being, like, oh, it's pretty good. Like, I got a really good card, like, luckily, but, like, I could have had... multiple really cool cards. So that kind of sucks. But, so, I could see if somebody's going to... if somebody is willing to drop money inside of a game, yes, this is probably going to be a game people are going to drop money into. And there's a lot of people who have dropped a lot of money into it. And I do know that for a fact. Like, a lot of fucking money. So.
Give me a number.
Probably close to 500 more. So.
Wow.
Yeah. We'll talk to you about that off air.
Okay.
Yeah. So I did that. I played some Rad Roger.
Cool. You're probably way ahead of me then.
No, I only did 2 worlds.
Cool.
Or two, levels. Two levels, yeah.
So only 1 world.
So, they don't, it's a lot of fun, and it's really easy to go through and stuff, but I really wish there was more, like, story sequence in between the levels. There's really not. Like, it just loads you in, and it's like, let's kick ass, and like, it's still fun.
It's probably story beats in between the worlds.
I'm hoping so. It definitely got really hard on, like, World 2 for some reason. And then World 3 wasn't too bad. But, like, World 2 was like, what the fuck?
Mm.
So...
it's a bit uneven in the difficulty.
Yeah. Or maybe it was just me and my platforming. Like, I'm not very good at platforming. I don't play a whole ton of them. Mm. But it was still fun.
Cool.
Killing shit. And then whenever I die, they gotta give me shit for it. So, that was pretty cool.
Yeah, the game definitely has that 90s attitude thing going on.
It definitely does. So, and then whenever you want to quit the game, it's like, yeah, I'm a quitter. So, and then I played some Fable Anniversarry, which is, alright, I mean, I jump in every once in a while and just take away at it. I beat that game so many freaking times.
It's funny you keep going back to it.
Yeah, it's just fun to go back and hang out and destroy a shitload of people, so.
Cool.
Yeah. Sometimes I go around and I do really good things and people are like, oh, I love love you. And I loaded in my other game where I was, like, destroying people, and, like, my guy does this, like, this fire thing that, like, basically summons the devil, and, like, the flames all come up around him and, like, kills everybody that's, like, within, like, a huge radius. And, of course, I had that maxed out on him. So then I just go around town and, like, kill a bunch of, like steal a bunch of stuff from,
just
like, shops.
Just walk around and burn everybody.
Yeah, well, or, like, just, like, get a shitload of people pissed off of me. So then, like, they all swarm me to attack me, and then I do that and kill them all. And I have, like, little flies that fly above my head because I'm so evil and I've got horns, and it's pretty cool.
Sounds like you enjoy playing evil better than good.
Yeah, it's a lot easier. It's a lot easier pissing people off and forcing people to marry you. Yep.
Good times.
Yep, kicking in doors while people are sleeping and killing them. It's pretty fun.
Yep. Maybe you shouldn't play this game anymore.
I mean, it's okay. So,
Tech Talk. So a while back, after we built my PC, I had some old speakers, like I bought at a garage sale for $10 or something.
Yeah.
And I did that annoying thing where if you try to adjust the volume, it would get all crackly and then the volume would go away.
Yeah.
And they kind of sounded crappy anyway. So Best Buy had an open box sale on this, and I had a coupon, and long story short, a $75 soundbar I got for $24.99.
Nice.
This is the Insignia mini soundbar, and for its size, it puts out a decent amount of volume.
Hmm.
It has optical input and left and right, so it's just stereo, but it's got a decent amount of bass. It actually has some screws I could mount it, but it fits right under my monitor.
Oh, that's so pretty nice.
Really easy.
Yeah.
So it just, it's kind of flush and just out of the way. Simple controls, power up, down. It does have Bluetooth if I wanted to sync my phone to it or something.
Yeah.
I'm probably not going to do that. And it came with a remote that I've already lost because I don't need it. The buttons are right here.
Yeah.
But it's simple. It does its job. It fits my space pretty well. I have a space similar in size to yours where I could theoretically put a surround sound system, but
it's just so small.
It's just so small. So often I'm using my headset anyway, but for what I'm not, this really does the job.
Nice.
So, pretty happy with it.
That's awesome.
Yep.
Cool.
That's my Tech Talk.
Awesome. Well, guys, that's our Tech Talk, so we will be right back after this. Oh, wait, hold on. So, we're just going to do this again really quick, but we're going to wash our ears with this promo.
Okay.
Because we actually have a commercial break.
I do need to wash my ears.
Yeah, so we need to wash Tim's ears, and we'll be right back after this.
There's a whole bunch of podcasts out there. You're not getting to listen to all of them. Join me, your Uncle Blake, and let me be your podcast Sherpa with the Earwash Show. I'll present a different podcast on each episode for your consideration. If you decide you like it, hey, give it a download. If not, well, I'll try again on the next episode. Besides my favorites and Apple's top picks, I want to hear what your favorites are so we can share them with the rest of the world. So send your favorites to earwashshow@gmail.com. Again, that's earwashshow@gmail.com. And let's get the good word out.
And we are back. Tasty treats in hand, guys. This week we're going to be going with the Shadow Ninja IPA from Lua Brewing.
Old favorite.
So, we shall.
Any luck finding a beer fridge?
No, not yet. Haven't looked again.
You should have a stack of cube-like things in your garage.
Might freaking have to.
Guns and beer.
Such an
American redneck. What would that tit box look like?
I don't know.
Did I tell you that one of the persons I work with
has a tit box?
No, she used to be in the kitchen, and now she apparently works at, like,
the woman used to be in the kitchen?
Well, she used to work in my kitchen.
Oh.
Now she works at one of those coffee places, the bikinis.
Oh, like bikini baristas.
Yep.
Really?
I thought that was funny.
Which one?
I don't know which one. I just saw a random snap she sent where she was working in one. I'm like, oh, so that's what you're doing now. Congrats.
Cheers to Ricky. Cheers to bikini baristas all around the world.
Mm. Love that ninja.
I love the ninja. All right, Tim. You ready to kick it?
Let's kick it.
Kick us off, Tim.
So just a little while ago, we talked about some football, as in the big game, whatever we're supposed to call it. I played this, I think, on an arcade machine. I might be wrong. If I am, I apologize. Mutant League Football.
Okay. I do remember playing this at, like, PAX or something. It was on Steam, I believe.
It could have been. I thought it was a Sega Genesis game, actually. I get confused. But basically, it's a football game, and you're a bunch of mutants, and you kick the crap out of each other as decapitated heads flying. Yeah,
you beat the shit out of each other, basically.
And there's, like, saw blades and yeah, like, flames coming out of it. So it's barely football, so that made me interested.
It's NFL Blitz.
But there's monsters
exactly,
and decapitation, so
yeah,
it's awesome.
Yes.
So I'm going to let the guy talk about it now.
Hello, Kickstarter. I'm Michael Menheim, creator of the original cult classic video game, Mutant League Football. And we've been working hard on the spiritual successor, Mutant Football League. Come on, check it out. MFL is an NFL Blitz arcade-style football game with nasty mutants, deadly weapons, dangerous fields, and lots of player deaths. The game is near alpha and fully playable now. We're planning to release it on the PC, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4. MFL offers a single-player experience, but it's most fun when playing with friends, either online or offline for 2 to 4 players. It offers both competitive and co-op multiplayer modes, so you can laugh at your friends while you crush them under your cleats, or team up and destroy all who dare to challenge you. This is the wildest, goriest, most outrageous football game ever. Players inflict maximum carnage on the opposition with punches, kicks, bombs, and even chainsaws. You can win by scoring more points than the opposition or by decimating the opposing team and sending them to their graves. Crazed fans cheer on their teams in packed stadiums laced with diabolical traps and hazards. There's no shortage of mines, toxic moats, and lava flows. And hey, if the hazards don't kill you, the weather probably will. Skeletal deadheads, armored bruiser bots, and monstrous orcs make up 14 vicious teams of fully 3D characters. All-star players are wisecracking mutants who have uber skills and abilities. These players are your game breakers who can single-handedly win you the game. MFL also breaks the rules with its playbook of dirty tricks. Each team has its own set of twisted dirty tricks like Chainsaw Massacre, where your running back pulls out a chainsaw and slices and dices the defense into sushi, or become ginormous and watch your blitzer grow 5 times his normal size and crush everything in his path. So that's the game, and now you've seen all the fun and chaos that comes with Mutant Football League, and we're almost ready to share it with you. We just need a little help to cross the goal line. We've got a playable PC demo for you to check out and play, just so you can see how much fun it is to bust some heads. If you like it, become a backer and score some awesome exclusive MFL rewards. Thanks for watching. Thanks to all of our supporters who have helped us get this far. Game on.
So as you heard, it's pretty much the same game, except they switched football and league around. And it's for modern consoles and PC.
Nice.
So they're asking for $60,000.
Okay.
And they've got 27 days to go as we're recording, and they're already at $69,000 and some change. Yeah. For $1, you get a sneak peek preview.
Oh, yeah.
So that's kind of cool. You get a Steam account and an Xbox controller, and it's not a finished product, so you encounter some bugs. But you can get a demo for $1. That's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
For $25, you get the actual game and beta access. So, not just the preview. That's kind of your minimum.
It's kind of expensive.
Yeah. I mean, $25 for a PC game. For a console gamer, that's not such a bad proposition. Because console games are used
to... It's actually very true. Yeah, and actually, the more I think about it, because they already have a track record with it, so...
So, they say that they already have an alpha build, as you heard in the video. So this beta, they're saying will come in October of this year for PC.
Nice.
A couple months later for console.
Nice.
So bear that in mind if you have access to both PC and console. For $29, you get the digital value pack. You get the game, digital soundtrack, and digital playbook.
Nice.
And the art of Mutant League Football.
Hmm.
Moving on up to the top tier, which is a ways down. Oh, it's all gone.
Oh, shit.
Someone spent, or two people spent $5,000 to own an MFL team. Sit back and consult or roll up your sleeves and help us design your own special MFL team. Working with Michael Mendheim and other MFL team members, you'll help design the logo, the name, your players, your team's playbook. In addition, you will help name and design the team's arena and hazards. Names and images subject to approval, of course, but this will be a bloody legacy like none other. Includes team name, name the stadium, help design team logo, name two all-star players, name 17 starting players, name two enforcers, two MFL jerseys matching your in-game all-star players, two custom all-star portraits, two all-star player statues, and four games to share with your friends. And all rewards are in a collectible retro Genesis case, so it wasn't Genesis.
Okay.
And like I said, that's already gone.
Holy shit.
There's actually another one for just for only $4,500.
Only $45. All right, Tim, we got this.
It's similar. You get a legend player in the game, golden statue of the player, the name of the statue, golden physical player statue. So you get like customizable stuff for the game.
That's cool.
There's four of those left. So
how many sold?
Four. None of them.
Oh, okay.
So yeah.
Cool.
Check that out if it sounds interesting to you.
Sounds good.
About the only football game sounds interesting to me.
Yeah, though that would have been more interesting than the football game I watched last Sunday.
Yes.
So there
should have been decapitations and
I wish.
Flames.
So guys, Tim is. Excuse me. Tim is all about that tech, so I found... I ferned the Turn Turk. I found the Turn Touch. Beautiful control. Now, this is a controller made out of 100% wood, and it is a remote, but instead of me talking about it, I'm going to let the developer talk about it.
This is a remote. It doesn't look like one, and that's a good thing. A touch dims the lights. A touch controls the music. A touch becomes a simple and quick way to talk to your home. Meet Turn Touch, a solid wood remote that controls devices, lights, and apps with a simple touch. Begin your day with one push of a button, and your alarm silences, the lights turn on, and the thermostat turns up the temperature. With Turn Touch, you can quickly wake up your house so you can focus on getting yourself up. You can even use it to read the news. Turn Touch can connect to any plug-in in your house. Use it to control a tea kettle, your speakers, even a lava lamp. And because the remote connects to your phone, you can take it anywhere, like your backyard. Use it to play music, practice yoga, or take a selfie. Sculpted from natural wood and mother of pearl, each remote is unique. At home again, stay focused by using your remote to make it just right. It's easy to find the lighting you want without distraction. And when it's time for bed, press a single button to put your house to sleep. Dozens of apps fit neatly into only four buttons. Turn Touch. Beautiful control.
I'm Sam Clay, founder of NewsBlur and creator of Turn Touch. I built Turn Touch because I wanted a simple way to seamlessly control my Mac and my smart devices without having to pull out my phone. I carved a lot of wood to get here. I chose to make my remote out of solid wood because I wanted it to feel more like furniture than a gadget. This is your light switch. This is your power switch, your newsreader, your alarm clock, even your DJ. You can use this remote with or without having any connected devices at all. Turn Touch. Beautiful control.
So as you guys just heard, that comes in three different finishes. It basically can control all of your smart devices from your house key locking mechanism.
Smart devices, anything that plugs in, it can control.
Exactly, anything that plugs in. You guys can make coffee in the morning, turn the lights on.
That's what I would want to do.
Yep, and that was exactly.
Turn touch, make me coffee.
Yeah, turn on the lights, turn on the lights downstairs, turn on the heater a little bit higher, and make me some coffee. I'll be up in 25 minutes.
That'll be all right.
Yep. So, has an extraordinary design. It's always ready. It's built to last. It can stand up the drops and shock. Its entire circuit board can be inexpensively replaced with newer future wireless tech. You also won't have to buy a new remote every time Apple comes out with a new phone.
Which is about every year, right?
Yep.
It is every year, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. So now it's ready to connect with over 24 apps and integrations. It also is just the this is also just the first version.
I bet there's a lot of if this then that.
Probably.
Yeah.
So, comes in three different types of stains. I'm trying to scroll down to the stains, mahogany and maple. So you have the outsounding, or the outlying, and then you have the inlay, padauk and satinwood. Rosewood and
sycamore,
and mother of wait, what?
Mother of pearls, the thing on the
back. Yeah, mother of pearls on the back.
All have that.
Yep, they all have that. Sorry, I'm really stupid sometimes, but that's exactly the reason why you guys tune in and listen to us.
How much does one of these bad boys cost you?
So one of these bad boys right now, if you get in before the early birds are gone, is for the mahogany super touch. Is going to be $59. You save $20, you receive one TurnTouch carved from golden genuine mahogany and white maple, engraved with mother of pearl. So there's 31 left of 150 at $59. Jump up to 60, you get the TurnTouch mahogany as well. For 69, there's 100 left of 100. Or if those are both gone by the time you guys hear this, $79 will get you one. $99 will get you the Paduke, Rosewood, $99. The complete set, Early Bird, is $229, so you guys will get three of them. Jumping all the way up to the big bad boy that we all like to talk about is $799, the Get It Now set. Get a complete handmade three-pack shipped as soon as this Kickstarter ends. Then once production is up and running, get a second set delivered off the fresh off the line. So you guys get one mahogany turn touch, handmade. One handmade mahogany turn touch, one handmade padauk turn touch, one handmade rosewood turn touch. Then you guys get a separate mahogany production turn touch, padauk production turn touch, and a rosewood production turn touch. And that again is $7.99. There are 9 left out of 10. Right. So somebody's already bought one.
Someone's gotta have it now.
Yep, somebody's gotta have it now, guys. So that again is the turn touch by Beautiful Control. They need $25,000. They are $10,017 with 125 backers and 30 days to go.
Cool.
So.
That's our kick it.
That's our kick it. Guys, ready to talk about some game news?
Yes, you got a whole bunch loaded up for us today.
I did.
So, Fallout Shelter. Won a lot of praise on both iOS and Android.
Yep.
It's now out on Xbox One and Windows and is Play Everywhere compatible.
Yep. So,
those of you who haven't played it on your phone can now play it on your bigger screen if you want.
Yeah, exactly. It's starting to become a very expansive game.
They've made a lot of improvements to it. There's a lot more going on than when we started playing it.
So, I spent money on this game before they had the cloud backup. And so now I don't have any of that shit I spent money on.
That's lame.
Yep. So I've heard they've emailed the developers. They're pretty understanding. So
do you have any way to prove you've spent money?
I have my statement. I have my Google credits.
Yeah, just keep a copy of that. You'd probably be cool.
Yeah. So, yep.
This next bit of news is for Q.
Yep. So the Nintendo Switch FIFA, EA, has officially confirmed that they're going to be bringing FIFA 18 So Chief Operating Officer Peter Moore told Game Reactor, "We are custom building a FIFA version for the Nintendo Switch. It will be FIFA 18, and it will obviously be later this year when FIFA 18 comes out. Soon after FIFA was announced for a Switch, rumors emerged that Nintendo version would be based on the edition that comes out on PS3 and Xbox 360. Moore responded at the time by saying FIFA will be custom built for Nintendo Switch.
So I'm confused. It's custom built or it's based on PS3 and Xbox?
It's custom built for the Nintendo Switch.
Okay. So they changed their message? Oh, rumors. Okay.
Rumors said it was going to be based off of the PS3 and the Xbox 360.
Well, that's good that it's made natively for the Switch.
Yep. They asked him if it could be more like the PS4 and Xbox version, Xbox One version, or it's going to be more like the PS3 and the Xbox 360. He replied saying, "What you have will be a custom-built version of the Nintendo Switch from the FIFA development team in Vancouver."
So this sounds a lot like the Wii, where like Call of Duty had its own special version.
Yeah.
Just for the Wii.
Exactly.
And it was not the best version.
So EA CEO Andrew Wilson also said that FIFA 18 will build on the foundation created with story mode this year, bringing players back to the journey with Season 2, featuring new characters and new storylines. The journey was story-driven and introduced in FIFA 17 that sees you, a young footballer called Alex Hunter. It featured dedicated characters, cutscenes, and appearances from real-life players and managers. So, fuck me. I kind of want to go play that game now, because now it's got a storyline to it.
You played previous FIFAs?
I mean, I've had them. I played them with Q before.
Okay.
But they've never had a story mode.
Oh, there you go.
There's a story
this
mode.
This is not a launch title, though, so it'll be a while out. Probably fall, I'm guessing.
Probably. I'll probably go back and play FIFA 17 if they're going to continue the story of Alex Hunter.
All right.
Giggity.
All right, so Final Fantasy 15.
Yep.
Took about 10 years to develop.
Yep.
That's a lot of money for Square Enix.
That's a lot of years.
It's a lot of years.
I mean, I'm sure some development team people have died because they got old.
Possibly. Game director Hajime Tabata says that the game broke even in just one day when it launched November 29th, 2016.
Fucking crazy.
It shipped 5 million copies on the first day. That's not necessarily a sell-through number, but it shipped 5 million. The figure rose to 6 million copies shipped. Company's not yet said how many copies of the game had actually been sold to consumers. Before Final Fantasy XV came out, Tabata said the game needed to sell 10 million copies to be a success. He later clarified that statement, saying 10 million is the studio's personal goal, not necessarily how many units it needs to move to turn a profit. So even though they broke even, like they're counting on this to be a tentpole game that makes a lot of money for them to pay for future projects. So even though they broke even the first day, they need this game to have a little bit of legs to make it worth the investment.
And I haven't heard people talking about it.
No, so, I mean, they're putting a good face forward, but I'm not sure this is the wild success that they were hoping for.
No, I don't think so.
And I also think it's really weird that they're not just putting out patches, but, like, story patches.
Yeah.
Like, I'm glad I waited. I'm kind of interested in the game, but I'm glad I didn't buy it day one, because they're adding story bits, like, main story bits.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, shit.
So I will get a better version now than someone who bought it and played it day
one. So this
one.
Is like Destiny all over again.
In a way, but
you get rid of the Dinklage and put in.
Yeah, but this is more of a story-driven game than a big arena to level up your character.
Right, true.
Like there's a definite story arc in this game.
Hmm.
So, good luck, Square Enix.
Yep.
Hope you get those 10 million copies eventually sold.
Yeah, hopefully. So, moving on over, Phil Spencer said 2017 for Xbox One will hold exclusive games more than 2016 did.
That's good.
The executive...
I saw the list. I published the list on the Button Smashers of what's coming out exclusive for Sony.
Uh-huh.
And it's a nice list.
Is it?
It is. So, what does Xbox have to bring to the table?
So, the executive tweeted out that he'll think it's going to be a good, quote-unquote, good year for Xbox, at the same time stating that the platform should have more first-party games than last year with great diversity. He also teased a new IP, but he also later clarified his comments by saying he was referring to Rare's upcoming action-adventure Sea of Thieves. So 2016 held Gears of War 4, Quantum Break, Recore, Superhot, while meanwhile Crackdown 3, Cuphead, State of Decay 2, and the aforementioned Sea of Thieves are among exclusive games confirmed to be on the way to the Xbox One this year.
We've been hearing about Crackdown 3 like forever, since the Xbox One launched, and they were talking about doing shared computing so they could have these giant open world destructible worlds. So I really hope that they bring something with that one game, like Crackdown 3.
I'm more excited for State of Decay 2, even though I can't finish State of Decay 1. Although I did see a leaked footage from like State of Decay 1. It wasn't really leaked, but I mean, it's out there, obviously. But I stumbled across it, and it looks like there's a huge fucking city. So now I'm like, shit, I gotta get out of the fucking farmland and go to the big-ass fucking city and kill some shit!
You gotta get past that sticking point you always...
Yeah. I gotta find some hack or something just to make it fly right by so I can get out of that area. Anyways, he said 2017 list is set to be bigger for Xbox One. With Project Scorpio launching this holiday, Microsoft may not show off it off until E3, but the company has said development on the system is coming along great. Spencer has been extremely active on Twitter as of late. Most recently, he discussed the possibility of Xbox 360 backwards compatibility on PC. He has also confirmed Project Scorpio will play some games in native 4K and tease Xbox E3 showing. So they're not really telling us what games, other than the ones that did not come out this year, they're expected for next.
I could use some more concrete examples, personally. Oh, well.
Well, I mean, I'm pretty comfortable saying that they had 4 exclusives last year, and we know 3 are coming. So, I mean, they're pretty good. So, if they just add another 3 or another 4 or even 5, they double their number.
Yeah, they need to do that. That's what I'm saying.
I mean, even if it's Teletubby Telly Time or something like that. Or, like, Over the Rainbow and Through the Woods, Murder Grandmother or something like that. Or like The Three Little Pigs 2K17.
You should name game titles.
I should.
Moving on to Bethesda.
Slaughterhouse Ponytail.
Appearing on a podcast called, Kinda Funny.
Kinda Funny?
Yes.
Kinda Funny.
Bethesda marketing executive Pete Hines said, Fallout 4 has got to be the most successful game we've ever launched.
Fallout 4, 2K17!
That we've ever launched. More than Skyrim in terms of what we did. It's not immediately clear by what he means by most successful, because Skyrim was released in November 2011, sold more than 20 million copies as of 2014, and Fallout 4, when it came out in November 2015, shipped 12 million copies on launch day. There hasn't really been numbers released since then, but it would seem that Skyrim would have the upper hand. Especially since Skyrim got a sales boost last year with the release of the Special Edition remaster. Mm-hmm. But according to this guy...
I'm wondering what they mean.
Yeah, but...
DLC is a hell of a lot more expensive than Skyrim ever was,
I think
too.
They might be just hyping the game they currently have out. But speaking of Fallout 4 right now, there is a high-resolution texture pack came out on Steam this week.
That's very true.
So if you're playing on Steam, definitely check that out.
Okay.
What else you got for us?
So, 2 years ago I played For Honor.
I think I watched you play.
I think you watched me play.
I might have played, I don't remember. I think if I did, I sucked.
So, For Honor is a dueling game, medieval style. So you have samurais.
Big old knight with... Heavy armor.
From different ethnic or mystical backgrounds. So ninjas and Vikings. And
I don't think ninjas so much, because they move fast. These are mostly...
Well, I guess not ninja. I didn't mean to say ninja. I meant to say samurai.
These are mostly slower, heavily armored.
Yeah.
Even the samurai wear armor.
Yeah. So, I didn't mean to say ninja. I meant to say samurai. So, samurai, Vikings, Nord, I believe,
Is that different than Viking?
Not really.
But, yeah, lots
anyways,
of...
Anyways, you get my gist.
Big guys, big swords,
yep.
Heavy armor.
So, they're going to be doing an open beta here, starting on February 9th. So, you can preload right now. Preloading is available for a client. It is about 27 gigabytes.
Wow.
The beta feature four modes: Elimination, Dominion, Brawl, and Duel. There are 9 heroes in the beta. The full game contains 12 heroes in 5 modes. So beta players are pretty much getting to try a good chunk of the game.
I would hope so, 27 gigs.
Yeah. As mentioned, this is an open beta, so everyone can jump in. And I believe it is coming to Xbox One and PlayStation 4.
Not PC.
Not that I know of.
And that's Ubisoft, right?
Yep.
Cool.
So, yeah, I'm excited for that.
Yes. You can get the next story, too, because I don't care about this game.
Okay, so, just so you guys know, FIFA is full of soccer, or foot-fucking-ball.
Football.
Foot-fuck-ball.
Football.
Foot-fuck-ball in other countries. Has a very good history of gambling. So,
how would you gamble in FIFA?
Well, I'm not really 100% positive, but we are going to learn about this, Tim.
Okay.
So, there have been fines levied against YouTuber against a YouTuber named Nepenthes, who admitted to gambling offenses while playing on his YouTube series of FIFA. So, he pled guilty in court actually today. And he was ordered to pay about $113,000, while Rigby must pay $217,000, according to The Guardian. The aggravating features of these offenses are they committed over a relatively long period of about 6 months, said District Judge Jack McGarva. Children were gambling on your site. It's impossible for me to know how many or the effect on them. In my opinion, both of you were aware of the use of the site by children and the attractiveness of it to the children. At the very least, you both turned a blind eye to it.
Making kids gamble.
Exactly. So, a YouTube video of Douglas was shown where he states, "You don't have to be 18 for this, because this is virtual currency."
Yeah, virtual currency is a weird legal area.
On Twitter this afternoon, Douglas posted a series of messages apologizing. "I owe a huge apology to my family and my close friends for putting them through this process, and appreciate all those that stood by me." He also said he intends to publish a video in due course presenting my side of this story.
Gambling with FIFA coins.
So the original story, guys, goes that the YouTuber Nepenthes had
He pleaded guilty,
but this was, he basically, you know, they convicted, or not convicted, they charged him with UK's Gambling Act, whose real name is Craig Douglas, and his business partner Dylan Rigby ran a site that allowed users to gamble FIFA coins, which is argued... hold real-world value on real-life football matches. The men reportedly pleaded not guilty at first, but then they have now obviously switched their pleas. The pair were charged in 2016 with inviting children to quote-unquote gamble.
So you'd make YouTube videos promoting the site to gamble on?
Exactly, and he had 1.5 million subscribers that were minors.
Nice.
So.
Sounds like a real stand-up guy.
Yeah, so good job, FIFA. Good fucking job. There's another reason not to play fucking Alex Hunter's goddamn story career mode.
You keep going back and forth on this game.
I really want to go play a story mode. I really like story modes in sports games.
Well, speaking of betas, PlayStation firmware 4.5 is currently in beta.
Yeah.
Several
Have
hundred,
you tried it?
I am not in it. I was not the lucky one to be chosen. Quite a few people have been, though, from screenshots showing up on Twitter. So it's definitely out there. So, there's some minor improvements, like getting choose your own background, smoother menu, like little improvements like that.
Yeah.
But there's three improvements that I'm excited about. One is you can now do external hard drives on the PlayStation 4.
That's pretty cool.
Which, you know,
has been a thing for Xbox for a long time.
And even Wii U.
Yep.
So, it's well timed that happens, but it wasn't an option before, so that's good. If you have a PlayStation VR, you can now, with the 4.5... watch 3D Blu-rays.
That's cool.
In 3D.
That's cool.
So you don't have to have a special TV or anything.
Yeah.
Of course, it only works for the person wearing the headset, but still, it's a cool feature.
Yeah, fuck everybody else.
Right. Then the last feature is called It's only for the PS4 Pro. It's boost mode. Improves performance on all games without pro patch updates.
Whoa.
So, like, Just Cause 3 ran pretty bumpy on PlayStation. Now with the
boost mode,
it runs pretty smooth. So people are showing side-by-side videos of, like, areas of The Witcher, whether it be slowed down or just other games, like, side-by-side. You can definitely see improvements in frame rate and performance.
That's crazy.
So that's pretty cool. That finally gives PS4 Pro players like me a reason to have shelled out the money for this.
That's very true.
So
that's awesome, though.
Setting 4.5 firmware for PlayStation.
Sweet. Sounds good. Well, we have some game releases, guys. Knight of Azure PC, February 7th, guys. That's what we're talking about right now. Uncanny Valley, PS4, Vita, Xbox One. Alterlier Sophie, The Alchemist of the Mysterious Book, PC. The Wild 8, Steam Early Access, PC. Nio?
It's either Nio or Nio. We're not sure.
Nio, PS4?
Game journalists aren't sure.
Quarantine. Oh, that's right. That's the word. Quarantine. Steam Early Access, PC. Brutal. PC.
It looks like brutal, but with an at sign.
It's kind of weird. Probably because Simulus already has a name, Brutal, in one of their games.
If I remember right, I think they use, like, ASCII characters as art.
That's weird.
I could be wrong.
Anyways, so Brutal, PC. That's all that's coming out this week, guys. Pretty short list. That's the reason why we had more stories.
You had a ton of stories listed there.
Yeah.
So there's a lot going on in game news. I read somewhere about someone getting kicked off of a team, professional team.
Oh, wow.
For dating viewers that were watching his stream.
No way.
So I was trying to... I couldn't remember the name, which game, which professional... Like, it was one of the games
It's probably Dota or something.
Something like that. So I didn't find the story in time to put it up there, but...
Lame.
The gambling story reminded me of that.
That's funny. Alright, guys. So until next week, don't forget you guys can check us out at youtube.com/plugandplaygame where you guys are watching this video to see what we actually look like and the weird expressions that we make and shit. You guys can also check out facebook.com/plugandplayshow, Twitter and Instagram @plugandplaycast, and check us out at thebuttonsmashers.com and plugandplaygamer.com. And until next week, guys, don't forget to prime and shine.